Good afternoon, everyone. First, let me start by saying what a horrific event today that affects not only obviously our Port Orange community, but all the family and Sugar Mill Elementary community, the students, the parents, the faculty. But our condolences go out to them, but really to the family of the student that was struck and killed today. On such a tragic event here close to the end of the school year. So to recap today, about shortly after 7 a.m. this morning, we received a call of a bicyclist hit by a vehicle. That bicyclist was in the crosswalk. The vehicle was leaving the school campus. The bicyclist, what we now know as a fourth grade student at Sugar Mill Elementary, was struck in the crosswalk by an SUV. The student, there were life-saving measures taken at the scene. The student was transported to Halifax, Daytona, but unfortunately it was pronounced deceased. The driver of the SUV did remain on scene, was obviously very distraught, but was cooperative. We're still working on that portion of the investigation. The family members did respond to the hospital. We sent police officers and our victim advocate up to the hospital to be with them. To offer any kind of assistance that we could possibly offer in a condition like this. And really, you know, it's a reminder, unfortunately, that there's still about a week of the school year left. So we urge everyone to be vigilant, you know, in these driving in particularly school zones, but in the area of any school. And as we head into summer, obviously, our kids will be out there in our streets, you know, riding bicycles, going to our parks, going to summer camps, so it's just a reminder, a tragic one, but for everyone to be vigilant and just use the utmost safety that they can when they're operating roadways where there potentially could be children. So I'll take questions.
Do you anticipate any charges against this driver?
At this point, I don't know, honestly. We're still really early in the investigation. I haven't received any knowledge as to whether there was distracted driving or anything like that. But that will be part of our investigation for sure.
Did the drivers give you any indication of why they did not see the child?
No, and that'll be part of our investigation. Quite frankly, the driver was very distraught, so difficult to talk to. We actually are probably going to have our victim advocate also reach out to the driver as well while we continue to investigate. But I think this morning, just because of everything that had happened, we weren't able to get that information.
Was the driver a parent of another?
I don't know what the familial relationship was, but it does appear that the person was dropping someone off at the school and was exiting the campus at that time.
And the child was in the crosswalk on a bike?
Correct. So if you see the overhead picture to my right, that is the crosswalk. It's on the eastern edge of the school property. As you can see, it's marked. The driver was exiting, and the child was entering the crosswalk going east to west.
Chief, where this is, do you have any indication, first off, how fast this person was going? The reason I ask is because clearly this vehicle was exiting.
Correct.
While the bicyclist was entering, but there's a stop sign there, so I'm just trying to get the proximity of where exactly and how hard this impact was, if the car was slowing down, speeding up, ignoring the stop sign.
And that I don't have. That'll be part of the investigation. We'll pull the data, as much data as we can from the vehicle itself. That'll give us a better indicator, or actually will hopefully give us that information, but we don't have that right now.
Is there a camera there?
Not that I'm aware of. We are actually combing that neighborhood just to see if it maybe even some of the home surveillance. We haven't located any as of yet, but we're checking for everything, you know, even as far as whether the homes have Ring cameras, so we could see if we can obtain any type of video whatsoever.
Who's in charge of
So the crossing guards are run through the county, through the school board, and are overseen by the sheriff's office. And they do all the hiring and training for them. We do not have crossing guards at Port Orange.
Was there a crossing guard at that crosswalk?
No, sir. Generally, they have, and again, this is out of my purview, but you'll generally see them when they're crossing major roadways, particularly intersections, when they're trying to get the children across safely, but that's probably a question for the county.
It seems like there have been, like, several incidents
We We can. I mean, obviously, we plan on having an increased presence, obviously, through the end of the school year. But we work closely with the school. There's been, we looked at some of that data already. We show 3 accidents dating back over the last 5 years. 2 fortunately involved relatively minor injuries until today's. The last one, I think the previous one, was in October of 2022. That involved the other crosswalk, and you saw that the school took some preventative measures with that other crosswalk area. That was a result of that crash in 22, so it's something that we'll coordinate with the schools. I spoke with Captain Todd Smith of the Sheriff's Office this morning. He was also at the scene. I was out there earlier. So we work together, and if there's any kind of improvements that we can, you know, coordinate, we will obviously do that.
And Chief, as far as Charles Street goes, I know that that's your jurisdiction with
Correct.
Your law enforcement department. Volusia County Sheriff's is the one who handles crossing guards. However, in your opinion or your line of duty, do you feel that crossing guards should be at entrances of schools where children are entering, whether it's by foot or by bicycle? Because it seems like 2 other entrances did have crossing guards, and this one does not, and has not.
Generally, honestly, you won't see the crossing guard, just in my previous experience, at the school entrances themselves. They're generally in close proximity, but usually, as I mentioned, at intersections. I couldn't begin to tell you how many additional crossing guards you would need if you were going to cover every entrance to every school, so I don't even know that that's feasible. But that could be a combination of the school's personnel, if they have anyone available that coincides, obviously, with the start of school. That could maybe assist with that. You do see some of that with some schools, just to assist with getting the parents and the students dropped off safely.
Do you know what those other instances were? You said one was in October of 2022 in that kind of crosswalk to, I guess, the left. Do you know when those were and what the minor injuries were to those other kids?
The one in 2022 was also a child on a bicyclist. That case, fortunately, the child was also on a bicycle, was knocked off the bicycle, but fortunately didn't suffer serious physical injuries. The driver in that case did leave the scene, but we were able to identify her, and she turned herself in after the fact, so there was an arrest in that case. The one prior to that was back in 2021, and that was actually on school property in the bus loop, but from what I've been told, that was minor injuries. You know, that's a combination of everything, right? It's the drivers being vigilant, you know, being aware, especially that you're that close in proximity to a school, but also on the kids, right? That they're wearing their safety equipment, that they're, you know, like we all probably, right? Everyone taught their kids look both ways, you know, when you're crossing a street or entering a roadway. So it's, and by no means am I saying that the child in this incident was at fault in any way. That'll be part, obviously, of all the investigation and how we got to this point. But I think it's a combo of that, you know, of everybody doing their part to ensure school safety.
And Chief, based on, I'm just curious, this intersection where this crosswalk is, the vehicle, looking at this, was traveling south, wanting to go east. I'm just curious, is that like an intersection where typically there is traffic? Like, would they have an issue seeing cars coming down? Are there a lot of, are they trying to gun it out of there because of the traffic at hand? Like, what's the situation like there?
That actually is in the actual school zone. So no, I'm not sure, you know, how and why today's incident occurred. I couldn't really explain to you yet whether she just didn't see the child in the intersection, whether, like I said, whether she was distracted or not. We'll find that out. And just for clarity, so you know, we're talking about the vehicle's exiting here, the child was entering the crosswalk from this direction. It was generally struck right around here as his vehicle entered.
In the school zone, reduced speed limit, it was during the times that it would be in effect then?
The school zone for that area, for the morning time, would have been 7 to 8. This call came in roughly around 7:10. So judging on what the delay was in us receiving the call and from the time it was dispatched, but I would say roughly around the time that the school zone would have been in effect.
Chief,
but we'll verify that. Yes, sir.
This is the parent drop-off loop where this occurred? The crosswalk in front of where parents normally go in and out and drop off things.
I'm not sure if the school utilizes it that way. I do know that there is that there's a separate entrance, and I'd have to verify, but I believe that it is. I do know that there's also a VPK area towards the back of that entrance. So I would say yes.
To follow up on his question, is that where, as far as you know, is that where the bikers go? Is that where the, is that like where the bike lock area is for the kids?
That part, I do not know. Just seeing if my staff has any indication. No, I'm not aware.
I guess what message would you want to get out to parents ahead of this last week of school in the midst of this really tragedy?
Again, you know, as I said earlier, we have approximately one week of school left, for at least for Volusia County. It's just, you know, obviously we want you to be vigilant all year long, but this is just another reminder of how quickly things can go south. And unfortunately, in this case, this is the worst possible scenario for this family to have to endure this right here at the end of the school year. So it's just that. It's just a reminder to be vigilant, not just through the school year, obviously, as I mentioned, because kids will be out now for summer. And so we don't want to see another incident like this. At least I don't. Hopefully, again, for the rest of my career.
That other accident that you mentioned where the child was injured, where exactly was that? At what street?
Same street, Charles Street. It was the entrance. It's the entrance that's just a little bit west of this location. That's the one that the school board took some preventative measures with. If any of you were out at the scene, you saw those, the poles that were erected there. That was as a result of the prior incident.
This family, only child, is anything you relate to the family?
I don't have that information at this point. As I mentioned, we did send our victim advocate to work with them, and assist in any way we can, but I'm not sure what the family dynamics were.
Are you releasing the names of the child or the driver?
Not at this time. We're still in the process of investigating, and just in abundance of caution, I'm not sure who the family needs to notify, whether they're in state. You know, I just want to ensure that the family and the school has enough time to do what they need to do. But at some point, yes, we will.
Chief, you mentioned early on you were looking for video, bringing cameras, that kind of thing. Were there no witnesses to this?
That's what we're still trying to verify, whether actually someone actually saw the crash itself. There were people on hand after that called 911 and tried to render assistance, whatever assistance they could. But initially, I'm not sure that those people actually witnessed the crash itself. So they may have seen the aftermath, but we're looking for, and again, that's a good point. If there are any witnesses that maybe didn't stop this morning that actually saw the accident, we're asking them to please contact our traffic unit.
Impact-related, or did this child get caught under the car? Because again, as they're exiting, I'm just trying to understand possible speeds and things of that nature, how this all went down.
From what I know, I don't know how the injuries were caused at this point. I'm sure that will come out of what the extent of the injuries were as a result of the investigation afterwards, and particularly with the medical examiner's office. I don't have an indication that this was a high speed, obviously, coming out of the parking lot. So I'm not sure if the impact caused it or anything else that could have happened afterwards.
What was the age of the child? I don't know if that was released, but the age?
I'm being told, I was told a fourth grader, possibly 10 years old, but I can't confirm that for sure. Mm-hmm. All right, folks, thank you.
Thank you.